That came out wrong. I've always wanted to be a mom. I just, it's a lot more difficult than I expected it to be.
What did you expect it to be?
Oh, I thought I would have that bond, you know, that connection that you always hear about. That I should be able to know instinctually how to take care of my daughter, how to hold her, how to comfort her, how to reassure her, but that doesn't exist, so I don't really know why, except for the fact that I'm just a horrible failure.
So in your world, you're either perfect or a failure. There's no middle ground.
Well, I've always put pressure on myself to be good at everything, so why would being a mother be any different?
Is that why you've hesitated to get into therapy?
I told myself to give it time. That one day I'll pick up my daughter and that connection will be there. If I could just stop pressuring myself for a second, then one day I'll feel everything I'm supposed to feel. I mean, that has to happen. If it doesn't...
If it doesn't?
I can't let my daughter know that I don't want to be a mom.
I'm not saying it's going to be easier, but with Robin in treatment for postpartum depression, I have to believe things are going to get better.
What do we got?
Car crash. Female mid-20s. Head trauma. Unresponsive. Pupils equal and reactive. She wasn't wearing her seatbelt.
Pre-existing conditions?
Yeah, she's a new mother. She gave birth about 3 months ago. It was a single car accident. She wasn't wearing a seatbelt, and it looks like she drove right into an overpass.
Let's go.
Okay, let's start with a stat x-ray, get a CAT scan, get a loading dose of dexamethasone and a monitol drip. We should get a tox screen of blood alcohol. I want to know why a woman not wearing a seatbelt drives into an overpass.
That's the second time you've suggested that you don't want to be a mother.
Well, I didn't mean that. I mean, I'm not used to this therapy. You know, I've always wanted to be a mother. I want to be a mother.
It's just not what you expected it to be. This room is a safe place, Robin, and it's important that you be honest about your feelings.
Okay, but I mean, I'm not one of those people that thinks therapy fixes everything.
It fixes one thing. You know you have an illness and you're...
Yeah, I know. I mean, I know a lot of women have issues after they give birth. You know, there's that lack of sleep, there's hormonal imbalance. You know, I've always been able to figure out things on my own. I can handle this. You wouldn't know this, but I originally had planned to get pregnant in vitro. I wanted a kid so badly, I thought I'm gonna do this with or without a man in my life. Now Patrick is the perfect father, and here I am, the one making the mess of everything.
I'm sure Patrick's a great guy, but there's no such thing as a perfect father.
Well, I just meant that, you know, this isn't the way things were supposed to be. I had it all figured out.
You talk a lot about how things should be, but I don't hear a lot about how you feel.
I feel stretched too thin. That's how I feel. I feel irritated, I'm bitchy, I snap at Patrick, I don't wanna eat, I am angry, I feel a lot. But not when it comes to Emma. I feel nothing, and I feel, I mean, if you haven't noticed, I've also lost the ability to form a coherent sentence.
You're doing fine. How about your husband? How's that relationship?
Lost interest in sex, which makes me feel guilty and completely incompetent. But of course I blame him for it, and I get angry, and then I start to feel guilty all over again, and then that just becomes a whirlwind of all these impulses.
What kind of impulses?
Where are those CAT scan results?
On the way, doctor.
Are those the pictures?
No, that's the results of the blood panel. So the patient has no drugs or alcohol in her system, no history of epilepsy or any other condition that'll cause her to pass out at the wheel, and her last hospital stay was to give birth 3 months ago, and that went well.
There's got to be some sort of medical explanation. The police said the roads were fine, the car was sound. Something going on here. I want to know what it is.
I've done some research on postpartum depression, and I've already settled on a treatment plan that works for me.
Have you?
Yes, I want to start hormone therapy in conjunction with a nutritionist-supervised diet. I've read that a well-balanced organic diet helps balance the hormones, and I plan to exercise regularly.
Well, if you've got it all figured out, why are you here?
To please my husband.
In all my years of practice, I've never had a patient who successfully overcame anything for someone else. You have to do it for yourself.
Are you questioning that I'm qualified to make a diagnosis?
Only one of us gets to have a God complex in this room. I'm the doctor, you're the patient, and I'm telling you, you're in a world of trouble.
Maybe I should get a second opinion.
Be my guest. I've heard enough to determine that you're clinically depressed.
I don't think that taking a pill solves the problem.
I'm not negating your treatment plan. It's smart to include diet and exercise. The meds are meant to work in conjunction with our therapy and your lifestyle changes, so that the next time you want to turn right instead of left, maybe you'll think twice.
All right. See you next week.
With your current symptoms, I suggest we start out by meeting every day.
Not bad, huh?
It's up to you. You can either get serious or continue doing what you're doing now.
Okay. Fine. You win. I'll see you tomorrow. Same time?
Mm-hmm.